This video will show you how to install TCPython and the required accompanying programs. The installation process requires several steps, as shown. We recommend that you complete the steps in the order shown in this video, as many are dependent on previous actions. However, not all users will need to complete all the steps. The video will also show you how to open the examples files that were shipped with the software, and how to create new examples so that you can get started working in TCPython. In this video, I will use a Windows computer, but the process is similar on Mac and Linux operating systems. I'll address the differences during the video, so you can follow along if you use either of those systems. There are two ways to install TCPython, and this video will show you the simpler way, which bundles several popular Python packages with the ThermoCalc installation. As shown on the screen, this is the recommended option for users who are new to TCPython, but it is limited to the pre-installed packages. If you want more flexibility in the program, or intend to use additional packages, we recommend you use the more advanced method, which you can read about in the TCPython installation guide. However, if you plan to develop or run property models in TCPython, it is strongly recommended that you use the method shown in this video. The first step in the process is to install ThermoCalc as you normally would. If you already have ThermoCalc installed, skip ahead to the next step. If you do not already have ThermoCalc installed, install it now using the default settings that are appropriate for your license type. Do not choose the custom option, as this will not install the bundled programs we need for completing the installation. If you want to do a custom installation, or if you need assistance installing ThermoCalc, refer to the installation guides available in the Support Center on our website, or visit our video library to find the correct video. If you're watching this video on YouTube, there are links in the description. The next step in the process is to install an Integrated Development Environment, or IDE for short. Any editor will work, but we recommend that you use PyCharm, which is an open source software that gives you access to advanced features such as code completion. If you already have an IDE installed, you can skip ahead to the next step. To install PyCharm, navigate to the URL shown on the screen. Once you're there, find the version you want to install and download it. The free community version is sufficient for working with TCPython. You can pause this video while the software is downloading. Once the software has been downloaded, navigate to wherever the downloaded files are stored on your computer. Find the PyCharm installer and double-click on it to start the installation. Install it according to the instructions. We recommend that you keep all the default settings. Once PyCharm is installed, we must open ThermoCalc in order to make the ThermoCalc examples accessible from TCPython. Simply navigate to ThermoCalc on your computer and open the program. The examples will automatically become available in TCPython. You don't need to do anything else in this step, so you can close ThermoCalc. Once PyCharm is installed, we want to open the examples folder included in your ThermoCalc installation. Open PyCharm and click Open. Navigate to the TCPython folder using the paths shown on the screen. If you don't see the folders in the path, it may be because you haven't opened ThermoCalc, which copies the examples to the correct folder. If so, close PyCharm, open ThermoCalc, then close it, then reopen PyCharm. You should now see the correct folders. Click OK. If a pop-up window appears asking you to trust the source, click Trust Project. Click Project on the far left of PyCharm. The different example folders should now be listed in the left pane. To run a calculation with TCPython, we need to configure PyCharm to use the bundled Python interpreter. In PyCharm, click the No Interpreter text at the bottom right corner. Click Add New Interpreter, Add Local Interpreter. Choose Select Existing for the environment. From the top drop-down menu, select Python. Click the folder icon, then navigate to the ThermoCalc Python interpreter on your system. It is located in different places depending on your operating system, as shown on the screen. Select your added interpreter, then click OK on both windows. You want to use this interpreter for all your TC Python projects. Therefore, it can be useful to rename the interpreter so that you can distinguish it from other interpreters. To do this, click Python 3.9 or whatever your version number is in the bottom right corner of the window. Then click Interpreter Settings. In the drop-down list, select Show All. And in the new window, click the Rename button, which is a pencil icon. Write the new name of the interpreter. I will name it Python 3.9 ThermoCalc. Click OK, Apply, OK, and then OK again. You should now see the new name in the bottom right corner of PyCharm. For Mac installations, you need to set some environment variables, which I will go through next. If you are on a Windows computer, you can skip to the next step. In PyCharm, you can add environment variables in the configurations. From the top menu, select Run, Edit Configurations to open the Run Debug Configurations window. Click Edit Configuration Templates. Choose Python and click the button to the right of the Environment Variables text field. In the Environment Variables window, click the plus sign to add a new environment variable. The environment variables you want to add are listed in the TC Python Online Help. Everyone must set the top environment variable. Then select the correct additional environment variables based on your license type. Enter the purple text as the name and the text after the equal sign as the value. Click Apply on all three windows to return to your project. It should be noted that changes to the template will not change existing run configurations. They need to be deleted to obtain the new template settings. If you received a username and password to activate your license, you must complete this step before you can use TC Python. If you are using a file-based license, you can skip to the next step in this video. We have included an example file that can be used to activate your license. To access the examples, click the Project folder icon from the left menu and expand the Examples folder, then Miscellaneous. Double-click on example PyX-MO4 license to load the example. This example includes a number of different methods to help you interact with your license, such as activating your license online or offline, updating your license, or deactivating your license. The default is to run Activate Online, but if you want to run another method, scroll to the bottom and enable the method that you want to run by deleting the leading comment from that method and adding it to any methods that don't have it. Most users will activate their license online, so I'll activate that method. If you need to activate your license offline, you can read the instructions included in the example or refer to our documentation. To activate online, click anywhere on the code and select Run. When prompted, enter your username and password. The program will begin activating your license. Once complete, you'll see Processed Finished with Exit Code 0. The products you have a license for will be listed, as will information about your license. Now that TC Python is installed, you should run an example to make sure everything works correctly. To run any of the examples, click Project from the left menu and expand any of the folders to reveal the examples. Note that example PyX M02 will not run without additional packages installed. You can read about this in the example. To run any of the other examples, double-click on the example file to examine the code, then right-click anywhere on the code and select Run. If you set up everything correctly, you should see the example running in the Run pane. Once the calculation is complete, the results will appear in a separate window in the form of a plot. If the calculation did not run correctly, visit the troubleshooting guide in the TC Python help. Finally, we want to create a new project where we can write and perform our own TC Python calculations. From the top, click the menu icon, then File, New Project. Here you can choose where to save your project and which Python interpreter to use. I'll use the default location, but if you want to change yours, click the folder icon and navigate to the location of your choice. Now we'll select our interpreter. We want to use our previously configured interpreter, so click Custom Environment, then Select Existing. Select Python from the Type drop-down menu, then make sure that the interpreter you configured earlier is selected from the Python Path drop-down menu. Click Create and choose to open the project in a new window. Your new project will then open in a separate window. Right-click on the Python Project folder in the left menu and select New, Python File. Name the file as you like, then hit Enter. You're now ready to write your own TC Python script. We hope you found this video useful. You can learn more about TC Python at the TC Python videos page on our website. Don't forget to press the like button and feel free to leave a comment about the type of video you'd like to see next. We are constantly working to create new examples, so make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any new videos. You can watch all of our videos at thermalcalc.com in the video tutorials section.